Welcome back to the Hollywood News Channel, where we update you with the latest news of the day.
Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. In today's news, Ivanka advises the father on women's issues and has a significant diplomatic role, meeting with foreign leaders, while Jared is responsible for strategic planning, recently unveiling his plan for peace in the Middle East. However, Elizabeth Spears, former New York Observer editor, a newspaper owned by Jared, reportedly noticed during a visit to Jared and Ivanka's apartment that there was not a book in sight and that the pair had zero intellectual curiosity. In the 2019 book Kushner, Inc., it was revealed Ms. Spears had a difficult relationship with her employer, one that would eventually push her to resign. While others have apparently disputed with the no books claim, they only recall seeing a few art books or decorated curated books. Ms. Spears told author Vicky Ward about a time when Jared complained to her about a New York Observer story about the move of author Martin Amis from London to Brooklyn. Despite the story getting a huge following online, Jared allegedly insisted, "Nobody knows who this Martin Amis guy is. Nobody reads novels." Ms. Pierce said, she replied, "No, you don't read novels." This was just one disagreement in a string of conflicts during their time working together in 2011 and 2012. The pair frequently clashed on editorial issues that Ms. Pierce believed exposed Jared's shortcomings as both a publisher and a person. Ms. Spears had been hired because she came from the world of digital media, and the two of them worked together on a plan to turn the newspaper's fortunes around and make it profitable again. Under her direction, the newspaper did indeed enter the black. In return, Jared had promised to invest resources into the newsroom, but the funding never came and she eventually quit the paper. She told Ms. Ward that Jared did not seem to understand journalists, nor did he respect them. She said he'd be condescending to them and he didn't understand why anybody would go into journalism. He was like, "Why are these idiots taking these low-paying jobs when they could work in commercial real estate and make a ton of money?" He did not understand public service at all. Ms. Spears added that he seemed to have little editorial vision beyond being pro-Israel. She said, "When I first took the job, he wrote this kind of manifesto about what the Observer should be about. It was like 4 pages long and 2 of them were about Israel. I thought that was bizarre." The New York Observer has traditionally been about New York. Another gripe Ms. Spears had with Jared seemed to have no interest in good writing, but rather wanted a vehicle through which to flex his family's power. This meant he often wanted the paper to try critical articles about people who had upset his family, or glowing articles about ones they wanted to impress. One of the most controversial examples of this was when the News Corp's phone hacking scandal erupted in 2011 and Jared wanted to make sure the newspaper's editorial defended his idol Rupert Murdoch. However, Ms. Spears decided to defy him and published an editorial that was far less positive, which aggravated her boss. Reflecting on Jared's experience in real estate, she said, "You have a lot of people with mediocre skill sets and intellects who advance in that industry just because it is so small and incestuous. And they believe everyone else outside of that industry also behaves that way." She alleged that Jared would later tell her that there was not enough zeros in the New York Observer to hold his attention. That is it for today's news, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.
Thank you for watching the Hollywood News. Don't forget to like and share the updates to the latest information of the day.